Hello everyone, my name is Petr Večeřa, as hopefully all of you know, and I have prepared a presentation about data-driven testing. So let's get started. So what is data-driven testing? Data-driven testing is a testing methodology where test input and output values are stored in the files and loaded into variables in the test scripts. So the main thing about this is that the test input and output verification data values are separated from the test code. So this is like the main point of the data-driven testing. And also data-driven testing allows us executing the same test multiple times with a different set of data. So when we should use it? Data-driven testing is used generally when we need to perform like fixed set of operations over a large combination of data which represents the test inputs. For example, DDT can be often used with the login tests, and test data can be stored easily in the easily editable files like CSV or something like that. And these files can be stored in the central data source or even databases. So, not all the projects may be like good for the data-driven testings. But for example, the login tests are usually, or like licensing is usually in most of the projects. In this way, it can be definitely used. So some advantages of the data-driven testing. So repeatability and reusability. The same test can be easily executed multiple times with a different set of data. And also, it sets the clear separations of the test case and test data. So changes to the test case and script does not affect data. So yeah, when you have the test script and the data separated, and you need to only change the data, it's easily doable in the separated file, and you don't need to like look into the code and change it in there. Another good thing is that only scripts representing business logic needs to be changed in case of changing in the app UI or functionality. So if you imagine like some, for example, web form, and in this web form, with the new version, there are like new selectors or something which needs to be changed for the test to work. So you only need to change the business logic or the script which search for the fields, and you don't need to change the data or even work with them. There are some more advantages. Faster generation of the test cases. So after the function is written, it's easy to generate new test cases just by adding new data, and this can be also automated. I think that this is one of the main reasons why we would use data-driven testing. So we want to accelerate or progress or the test case generation. So we are making the test faster and better. Yes, data-driven test also results in the less amount of code, and code doesn't have to be touched or recompiled when a new test case is added. I guess this is one of the advantages. Like mostly the tests are written in the script languages like Python or JavaScript, so it doesn't need to be recompiled. But when we look, for example, in Java, and there are some bigger projects, this could be also advantages. And the last, it sounds cool. So when you are on some meeting and there are some high management who doesn't know anything about the code, and you say that you use data-driven testing, they may be impressed by the buzzword. And of course, it has to have some disadvantages. So quality of the coverage is strongly depends on the automation skills of the implementing person. So when you imagine that your task is to add the new test case, and you will open this data file which stores the test cases, and you just add a new line, And when you added this new line, you are not sure what exactly this test is doing. So, for example, if this test, this new line, like froze the, when the test is executed, this new line froze a new exception, which was not there before. And the person who was writing the business logic, like the function which executes the test, didn't count with this error. This new test case would not like catch the new error and would not be aware of it. Yeah, extra maintenance of next disadvantages is next extra maintenance of the code handling the data input files. So when you have your test scripts, you will need to have some like, I would say it would not be like big function, but you need some functions which would load the data from the files or from the database before the tests are executed and prepared. One advantage is like the test files and code might not be so clear to project newcomers. So imagine that you are new to the project and your task is to add a new test case. And you will open the project, you will find the test, and you will find the test script, and you will find the describes the is which defines the test cases. And now you will see that there are some functions which leads to some different files, and you will look into this different file. Then you will find out that it's loaded from like some CSV file or something. So you will go there, and there you would find the thing. So this might be advantages, but I think that it's not that big because as I wrote, one of the advantages is the less amount of code. So this is definitely worth it, like to use. And the last disadvantages might not be worth with small amount of data. So as with different approaches, it's not always useful to use data-driven testing if you don't have the like, for example, small amount of data, or the project is not like good for using it, because so don't try to use it if the project is not suited for it, right? It's like with everything. Okay, and we can continue to some live examples. So let me switch. So okay, this is some very basic. Basic tests. As you can see, there is something about DVPay, but don't worry, they didn't write it like this. In the DVPay, this is totally fabricated test. I only use some things of it. So this would be the most basic approach to writing tests. And as you can see, it's not only about the test, but it's a basic approach to programming. And there are some like quite, let's say it, bad things. So as you can see, this guy defines like the next test suite, and it describes us, like, for example, test case. And you can see what we have in here is code duplication. So in each test case, the code is duplicated, as you can see. So, and imagine this would be like hundreds of test cases with the same code. So this is a really bad approach, and I hopefully no one is using it like this in our company. And this is not just only about test cases; it's like a regular programming thing. So how to mitigate this? Is like writing functions with parameters. So let me skip in here. So this is definitely a better approach. So our code is like the code which like clicks and fires the test case is separated in the function. And this function has some parameters. We use, like, this is function for login. So this functions takes some person, which could be like object with credentials or something. And also it defines if the test case like should be true, like if it should, if the login should pass or if the login should throw an error. And as you can see, the tests are defined like this. So yeah, imagine that this function could be like separated in the different file. So we would call it this, so it's not confusing. So we would call the functions, and in each test case we would we call the functions and we would pass the parameters. So this is definitely a better approach, because when something changes on the page, the only thing where we need to change it is in here. So we would just rewrite the selector in here or add something new in this function. And I think that this approach is mostly used and is most common. And okay, and the next step is the data-driven approach, how it's different to this code. So data-driven approach. Imagine that this code of this function could be in here. So we have some test data which are defined in here, and then we have the tests. And imagine that this test data could be in the file. It could be in the file, or it can be defined directly in the code. As you can see, it's testing different. It's testing the same, but the data are written in here. And just to go through the code, so what it does is it takes this array, and for each item of the array, it fires a function. It's the it, which is test case. It's named login. It gets data 0, which is the name of the test case. So we have some pretty output in the end, and it takes the person credentials, which is email and password, and it takes the third parameter is the if it should pass or not. Like the login function should pass, all the tests should pass, like should be okay. So yeah, if you for example in here with an empty password, so we can see that the output should be false. And if you imagine that we would want to add a new test case, it's as easy as just writing a new line. So if let's say like full email and invalid password, empty password, for example, because we don't have this option here. We have only empty email and empty password. So full email and empty password, just like this, email@gmail.com. We have a new test case, and it was pretty fast. So it's definitely worth using it. And pretty useful. But as you can see, there is this disadvantages when the quality strongly depends on the person who implemented it. Because just now I added a new function, and I'm not sure what the login function does. I added a new test case, and I'm not sure what the login function does. So if this test case would throw a new type of error, which is not handled in the login function, I would not catch it. But okay. And if you would ask me if it's better to like separate the data into the separate file, I think it strongly depends on how much the data, how much of data we have, and how we want to handle it. So for example, with this login test, the data might not be so big. So it can be like, let's say like 5, 6, 4 more cases. So it's completely okay to define the data directly in the test file, because it definitely helps you. And you don't need to worry about separate file and loading the data from it. Okay, I guess that would be it. I can show you one more thing, how we use it in the real project. We use it in the Sanchi Architect, but I would say it's not the complete data-driven testing, but it's something, some hybrid between it. It's the parametric testing. So we needed to there are some project templates, and we needed to build them. And as you can see, this is some test file for these projects. And as you can see, the project names are defined in some array. And we have just a function, which is called template tests, which takes the template and another parameter, which defines the framework. And this was pretty useful, because when we wrote the test, we didn't have like this example. And when the new version of Architect came and there was added new example, everything what was needed in our test was just added this new line. And we had the new feature completely tested. And as you can see, this function is separate. It takes two parameters. One defines the template, and one defines the framework. And as you can see, it was used. There was many different combinations of these tests, like modern 6.0, 6.2, 6.5, so classic 6.5. And so we wrote only one function, and we were able to test like tens, maybe hundreds of different projects in the application. So yeah, it's pretty useful in this way. Okay, do I have anything here? Yeah, so conclusion. Should we use data-driven testing? Definitely yes, but only in the places where it makes sense. And the biggest advantages would be the faster test creation and easier to maintain the change when the changes are made. We need to only change the code or only the test data. Okay, that would be it. Do you have any questions in here? But I would not use. Well, where I would not use everywhere where it's not suited for, like I have seen some projects where it would not be like useful at all. So if each test case is different from the other one, there is no like repetition of the code or all the test cases, so it's not useful in there. So yeah, okay. Guys, do you have any questions? Who is on the Hangout?
Not me. Nope.
Okay, so I guess there would be all. We have no questions. Rasta, do you want to add something? So, thank you, guys. Yeah. Okay. See you, guys.
See you. Bye-bye.
Bye.